In social exchange and rational choice perspective, we move on to Peter M. Blau's exchange theory. In this theory, the goal is an understanding of social structure on the basis of an analysis of the social processes. Understanding of the social structure in the society. The different society is divided into different structures, different groups. The groups might be having different power positions. They are hierarchically arranged. So, goal is how that takes place, and we start with exchange and how that affects the social structure. So, processes that govern the relations between individuals and groups. So, basic question ye hai ki how social life becomes organized into increasingly complex structures of associations among men. Repeat, how social life becomes organized into increasingly complex structures of associations among men. Ye ek important, let's say, characteristic hai humari modern society ki, jisme ek division of labor hai. Different groups are performing different, let's say, roles, and these activities are exchanged, and the whole structure continues functioning. So maybe one structure is more important than the other one, but it is in operation, it is functional. One structure might be dependent on the other one, despite the fact that one is more powerful than the other one. The process of exchange directs much of the human behavior. So, there is exchange not only between individuals, there is an exchange between individuals and groups, there is exchange between groups and groups, there is exchange between collectivity and another collectivity. So, in this kind of exchange, we also see that there could be indirect exchange. So, exchange underlies the relationships among individuals as well as amongst the groups. So, within group, there is an exchange between the individuals. Then there is exchange between individual and the group. Then there is exchange between group and group. And there could be exchange between one collectivity and another collectivity. So, four-stage sequence leading from interpersonal exchange to social structure to social change. So, uska kehna ye hai ki pehli baat hai, pehli stage ki agar baat karein, personal exchange transactions between people, personal exchange between people, it gives rise to what? Differentiation of status and power. So, one has more power than the other one. The person who is providing the advice and the person who is seeking the advice, advice provider may be more powerful than the person who is dependent on that advice. So, that it leads to differentiation of status and power. Then thirdly, legitimization and organization which show the seeds of opposition and change. Aur ye jo differentiation power hai, it might be legitimized. Legitimized by the norms of the society, by the values of the society. Agarche legitimization hoti hai, but also it happens that in certain situations, this exchange ke norms jo hai, ya rate of exchange jo hai, that might not be, let's say, coming forward. So, people might feel that some injustice has taken place, and because of the injustice, they might oppose the powerful, and because of this opposition, it might lead to protest, and protest might lead to some kind of, let's say, radical kind of strike, and it could lead to change. So opposition exchange say, elementary exchange se aap dekhen ki kaise differentiation hoti hai. Differentiation mein kahin frustrations bhi aati hain, और यहाँ पर फिर ये frustration leads to opposition, it might lead to change of the system. So social exchange contingent on mutually rewarding actions. No rewards, no exchange. So exchange rewards can be intrinsic, just like love and affection, respect for the other, or it could be extrinsic, just like money or other labor. So parties cannot always reward each other equally. Maybe they have different resources, and the needs might be different for these services available at the other party. So it creates inequality in power relations. So there are four alternatives for a party needing something from another but has nothing to offer in return. So pehli baat yahi hai, agar uske paas kuch nahi hai usko dene ke liye ya jo kuch uske paas hai wo usko zarurat nahi hai, to pehli baat ye hai ki he might, that party might force the other to give the help. So that is a brutal absolute use of the power or the force. Dusra hai ke ye to nahi kar sakta, then find another source to get what is needed. Teesri baat hai ke zarurat to hai aur wo force bhi nahi kar sakta, kahin aur bhi nahi, aur se bhi nahi mila, then he might live without that. Aur chauthe alternative ye hai ke uski subordination accept kare, aur jab subordination accept karenge to yahan par phir power relations ki baat aa rahi hai. So processes of social interaction are part of the social structure. So social interaction exists first within groups, aur yahan par baat hai within groups. So people attracted if being in the group is rewarding. So person would like to interact with the group if it is rewarding. Phir agli baat ye hai ki kya group samajhta hai ki usko apne saath milaye to uske liye rewarding hoga, to kya wo uski taraf attracted hai. So differentiation emerges within group. To yahan par jab differentiation ki baat kar rahe hain, to some people might be having more power than the other. Some people might be the leaders, the other might be the followers, and there could be competition for these kind of positions, and positions people might have based on their capabilities, abilities, efforts, resourcefulness. So differentiation within group and between the groups is inevitable. So sabke paas resources nahi hai, sabke paas let's say apni needs fulfill karne ke liye shayad resources nahi hai, to they are dependent on the others. So that is how the differentiation comes. So it lays the groundwork for opposition, or phir kabhi opposition yahan tak ho jati hai ke people might feel deprived of some of the rights, it might lead to conflict. So exchange ka agar rate violate ho gaya to phir yahan par conflict aa sakti hai. So as the social structure becomes complex, the relationships also become indirect and complex. That is the quality of the modern society, where there is a lot of division of labor. So there is a complexity of the society, different structures, interdependence of these structures. So there could be direct exchange, there could be indirect exchange as well.